everybody. Happy Saturday. How are you today? I hope you're doing great. Today is Saturday, June the 11th in the year 2022, and you are watching Allie's View. I'm Allie. If you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please hit that subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up, and without any further ado, let's get going. Guys, you all know I always like to let you know what today's date is. Like I said, June the 11th in the year 2022. In case you are watching this video, I like to joke and say 100 years from now. If there is such a thing as YouTube and people are looking back to see what's been going on in the world. Well, I tell you what, guys, we have had a lot, and I do mean a lot, going on in the world. Just continued and continuous, all kinds of stuff. You name it, it's going on somewhere in this world. And of course, over here, we are trying to see what we can do to make some money. And I will say, Friday's stock market, for people that were engaged with puts, you guys were making a lot of money. But people who were in call options, maybe not so much. Who knows? But anyway, the market took a nosedive, as you guys know. And it's really been kind of fluctuating like that. You all know I'm no financial advisor, but I've said before and I will say right now, I still felt like we were not out of the bear market ditch. And, you know, it's not great for anybody's portfolios, but it's a perfect time to buy. Buy when these prices are extremely low. I'm no financial advisor, but when these stock prices are extremely low, that is the time to buy, if and only if you can afford to and you have some money that you can spare, because you can see your money multiply big time by getting in when they're low. I mean, buy low, and if you decide to sell when they go up a little bit, make some profit and keep the wheels moving. When you see profit, take profit. You guys already know. Shout out to everybody, the Chris Sain Challenge. Guys, this is the end of week number 23 in the Chris Sain Challenge. For those of you that have been following along with me, you guys know this is my second year in the challenge, and I'm trucking along, clawing my way to 100K, guys. And I do mean that. I mean, I'm going to keep trucking in this journey until I get there. So without any further ado, just to talk a little bit about last week, you guys, hopefully you saw the video that I put out right after I released the previous week's video for the Chris Sain Challenge. The next thing I know, I looked in my portfolio late that night, early Sunday morning, late Saturday night, and I saw the airdrop. That's right, Voyager and the people from the Luna Foundation, they sent me my airdrop. So I was all excited about that. And also on Tuesday, following the airdrop, I also got an email from them. And in that email, they basically communicated the fact that they had sent that information to my Voyager account. And for those of you that have Voyager, thank you to those that have subscribed here on Allie's View and used my referral link. If you want to use Voyager to buy your crypto, there is a referral link. And guess what? They are now giving $50 in Bitcoin to you and to me for the referral. So please, if you like crypto and you decide to buy yourself some crypto, consider buying your crypto using the Voyager app. They will give you $50. It was $25, but now they're giving $50. They will give you $50 in Bitcoin and give me $50 in Bitcoin for the referral. So, wow, look at Voyager. But anyway, going back to Voyager, I got a got the letter or the email from them advising of the fact that they had made that deposit. So I thought that was interesting. that they were able to send that to me. And let me see, I was gonna see whether I could find that in my email, but it looks like it's taking a little bit longer to get a hold of it. But basically it just told me that they had deposited the airdrop and that the locked Luna was there and that the Luna 2.0 was there. And they gave me a total of 47. And there's another video where you can see the previous video to this one. You can see what's going on in my portfolio as far as Luna is concerned. Now, am I gonna buy some more Luna? I don't know. I may buy some more. It's dirt cheap right now. I always liked Luna. You guys know that. When I started talking about it here and what I thought that Luna could do before the crash, who knew it was going to crash? Golly, as Gomer Powell would say. Who knew? I surely didn't. But right now, Luna is trading at $2 and some change. And it was at like $5 when they made the deposit of the Luna that they had put into my account. You guys might remember I had 46 Luna token that I had purchased, and they all just, it had grown up to, you know, $100 and some odd by the end of, by a couple of months ago, actually. And then of course, when the crash happened in May, all of that just went away. But they gave the 47 Luna tokens between the locked Luna and the actual Luna 2.0. So we'll see what happens with that. I may buy some more Luna. I don't know. I mean, Luna did me dirty, as my homeboy in the from here on the channel communicated, and we all know. And who knows? I liked the actual concept and what they were doing. So I may buy some more down the road, but that's not my priority. You guys know I've been talking about Amazon. I did buy a few dollars, and I mean a few, tiny, tiny amount of fractional shares till I can get to buy a whole share of Amazon. So I did do that, and I'm excited about that. And also, I saw yesterday, I read where Tesla is going to do a 3-for-1 split. How about that? We've been talking about it here on Allie's View. So I want to get some Amazon. I would like to get some Tesla. I'd like to get Google when it splits. And I really, really also want to get some Shopify. I've got a couple of Shopify stores, so would like to buy some Shopify. So with those things, to start to build out this portfolio. Now, you guys know I have AMC in here. I think now I'm at like 73 total AMC. I bought a couple of AMC last week. I'm trying to get back to 100 before the squeeze. Everybody's talking about how it's going to squeeze, and I hope and pray that it does squeeze. And then I can take that money and do what I want to with it, or leave it in the portfolio instead of taking it out like I did the last time when it squeezed. Anyway, this is supposed to be the mother of all squeezes. So who knows? We'll see together. Anyway, I'm hoping that that will happen. Guys, one stock that you guys already know about, I'm sure, but I wanted to mention it here on Allie's View because, you know, you guys like to joke with me and, you know, kind of hammer me about me and my speculative stocks. Redbox, man, did you see that thing? I'll tell you, I looked at it last week and I started to buy an out of the money call option on Redbox last week when it was like $8.20. I looked at it just now before I came out to do this video. It's at 13. So they say it's gonna go on back up. I think it was as high as 20 some odd dollars previously. And they say it's in the middle of a squeeze right now. So something to think about. I'm no financial advisor, as you guys know, but I am looking with both eyes and shades, glasses, you name it, at Redbox, because it's in the middle of a squeeze. And you guys, I already know. I know firsthand how much money you can make if you get in at the right time, even if you buy out of the money. And out of the money is less expensive for people like me to be able to afford. And of course, it is somewhat of a gamble because you never know. And anything in the stock market is somewhat of a gamble because you just don't know for sure. But if you take Terry Egioma's course, Trade and Travel, there is a link in the description. Shout out to Terry and everybody in Trade and Travel. And those of you going to Miami, have some fun for your girl, Allie. I knew y'all were gonna have a blast in Miami. Those of you from Terry Egioma, Trade and Travel, that are going. But there's a link in the description where Terry teaches people how to identify buyer levels and seller levels and find where banks are buying and where banks are selling. And when you can get in at a buyer, great buyer level, and of course it's hard now in this current market in a way, but if you understand the seller level, understand the buyer levels, you can decide when to get in and when to get out in a more informed way. Of course, in life, nothing is guaranteed except death. Guaranteed. Not gonna be here forever and ever, amen. But you can be saved, and that is through Christ. So guys, without any further ado, a little bit more RUNE. I still got RUNE in my portfolio. I have 90 RUNE in the portfolio. RUNE is trading at like $2.57. We'll see what happens with that. if you're interested in getting Rune, I buy my Rune on crypto.com. There is a link in the description for crypto.com. Also, guys, wait till you hear this. I came across, and you guys probably already know about this, but I like to share with you things that I'm finding. I came across a neat app. It's called Uplink. And this, excuse me, not Uplink, Upside. I apologize, Upside. It's Upside. And there is a link in the description of this video, but they give you money back when you buy gas at these different gas stations. You know, you can get 14, 15 cent. If you use my referral link, you'll get 15 cent off each gallon in your next purchase at the time of this recording. But I think it's a good deal. I mean, gas prices are off the roof. And if you go and buy 10 or 15 gallons to fill your tank up, getting 15 cent, 14 cent off per gallon back into your account in terms of money that you can deposit in your bank account or in your PayPal or however you receive your money, it's a good thing. I think it's a good thing. And I'm always here to try to share things that I come across and I find that I believe are beneficial to me and can possibly be beneficial to you too, if you consider using them. What else did I want to talk about? Still trying to get a hold of cash. That's what I'm trying to work on, working on that. So that I can really get into buying while these prices are so great. Don't forget about the trading journals, guys. These are two different covers, but the same information are contained therein. These trading journals are for those of you that are out there that like to trade stocks like me, and it's a great place to keep a record of your trading. Your trading plan can be noted. Your trading system can be noted. And by the way, this book is created by your girl, Allie. That's right. If you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please hit that subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up, please. And help my video get trending on YouTube. This is where you can put your monthly goals. And of course, the all important trading logs. Like when you get in, when you get out, how many contracts you bought, how many stocks you bought, and so forth and so on. That's what the bulk of the book is made up of, because that's what we are trying to primarily log. It comes in two different colors, the black and the yellow or the gold, depending upon how you want to describe it. Also, my personal emergency log. I've talked about this here on Allie's View many times, and I'm going to keep talking about it because, you know, I love having one of these, and you may too. This is a place where you can, it's kind of like a life management journal. You can keep, and there's a link in the description for this, as well as the trading logs that we just talked about. There are links in the description for everything that I've been talking about here on Allie's View. But in this, it's really neat because you can really make note of your important information, things that you might try to keep in your phone, but if your phone crashes, then you lose everything. If you write this down and you keep it in a secure place, maybe even a safety deposit box in a bank, something to consider, your financial information. Just like to show you a couple of pages so you can kind of see what's in here, your credit information. Also, there's a place where you can prepare for your last days, like your funeral service, if you want to even have one of those. But this is a neat resource for you to share with family members or a family member that may very well be in charge of your estate or in charge of taking care of you, like a power of attorney, something like that, in the event of you being in an emergency situation, or even if you don't even have to have a need for a power of attorney, but if you're in a situation where you can't get to all your passwords and your codes and you may not remember them, this is for your pet information. You know, I don't like to leave out the pets. you know, just keeping somebody aware of what's going on with you. And so, useful tool, emergency contacts. Like I said, there's a link in the description, and you can get one. They're available on Amazon. So guys, not a whole lot more. Like I said, take a look at the Upside link if you want to save some money on gas. I do have a video coming about that to tell a little bit more about it, but I thought I'd just mention it here. Also, I have to say, who are you going for in the Belmont Stakes today? You guys know this is the third leg of the Triple Crown. Not going to have a Triple Crown winner this year because Rich Strike did not participate in the Preakness. Who are you going for? Are you going for Rich Strike? That's that horse that won the Kentucky Derby. It was the long shot, the 80-1. Who are you going with? Are you going with Rich Strike? Are you going with, like, my mother? My mother likes, who does she like? I wrote this down so I could tell you. She likes Skippy Longstop. Shout out to my uncle in California. He likes different different horse races and things like that. He likes horse racing as a form of sports betting. Who do you got? Who do you have? Also, tonight we got the Stanley Cup continues for those of you that are into hockey. I like sports, guys. I'm sure you're finding that out as you continue to watch my videos. And today I am representing for the Golden State Warriors and Steph Curry. Those, my cousin brought me this. She went out to San Francisco and brought me this really neat shirt back a couple of years ago. I've been out to San Francisco. It's beautiful out there. But anyway, I'm a Laker fan. I know. Please don't hate on me. Don't hate on me. And I love Michael Jordan. I follow Michael Jordan when he was in college and, well, when he was graduating from North Carolina and continuing in the NBA and just doing great things. But like sports, and I'm looking forward to seeing what happens. Shout out to everybody that's a fan of sports. So guys, that's pretty much all that I've got right now. I'll be remiss. Happy birthday, Talil, my cousin Talil. In fact, I'm on my way to a party this afternoon, a 21st birthday party for my cousin Talil. All right, guys, that's all I got. If you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please hit that subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up. You are watching Allie's View. Let's get ourselves some Amazon. I'm no financial advisor, but let's try to get ourselves some Amazon. I'm still trying to get the out of the money call options. You guys know. And let's get AMC to squeeze. That's all I got. You guys have a wonderful rest of your day and let's go. Hi everybody, here we are at the end of week number 23 in the Chris Sain Challenge. And it's your girl, Allie. Guys, you've been taking a look at this. I haven't made very many changes. You saw these AMC call options that I got. This one was purchased on June the 6th. And then the other one was purchased back on May 27th with an expiration date of July the 15th. So we'll see what happens. I mean, I'm hoping the AMC will squeeze and let's say bye-bye to this play. I will probably keep at least one share of it when it's all said and done. I did get into just $10 worth of Amazon, and I intend to add more of Amazon as I continue to get money to do so. I've had a lot of little things pop up, and I got videos to show you guys. Some of the things I've had to have done, like some work to my car and just other things around the house. But that's what's going on inside of the Robinhood portfolio. Now, you guys may or may not have seen the video that I shared about Luna and the fact that they did go ahead and give me or put the shares back in there. And we've talked about this earlier in the beginning of the video, but this is the original, the Luna Classic. You guys remember me talking about that and the fact that I had 3,200 of these things, the original Luna. And then, of course, this is what they gave, or what they put back in my account. I won't say gave because nobody gave anything. I had what I thought was some type of value in this. And then, of course, you guys remember what happened. And I got lucky, I'd say, because I guess they could have just let this thing go all the way down the tube and flush. But of the Luna 2.0, they gave 14.543, you can see right there. When they put this in, it had a value of $5. So you can see it dropped down to $2.48. And if it does, like the old Luna did, who knows? It may very well take off and run. This is the locked Luna that you see right here, the locked Terra 2.0. You can kind of see I've got 33.933 of that. And it's just got a $1 value, and of course he can't unlock that until they say so. So that's kind of what's going on with this. And then I told you guys I got that email from them advising me of the fact that they had made the airdrop. Oops, wrong one. Crypto.com. Let's look at Rune and see what's going on in there. Now, not a whole lot going on. And by the way, if you're interested in buying Rune and you want to get it on the crypto.com, it's not available on Voyager. Otherwise, I would like to have bought it over there. But nonetheless,
I've got the 90 rune tokens over here on crypto.com. And if you decide you want to join crypto.com, there is a link in the description. And by the way, guys, if you want to save some money on your gas, there's a link in the description for up link. Take a look at that if you get a chance. There's going to be a video that I'm going to put out. The actual app looks like this. Upside, excuse me, not uplink. Upside is the name of the app. So I've got a video on that. If you're interested, you can learn a little bit more about saving. I'm going to put that video out here on YouTube as well. But for now, you can see Rune is trading at $2.44. And we're continuing to hope that this will skyrocket and take off. We'll see together. It's your girl, Allie. If you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please hit that subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up. And I look forward to seeing us continue to grow. I'm really excited, like I said, about Amazon, Shopify, Google, when it splits, when Shopify splits. And of course, we heard on Friday that Tesla's going to split 3-for-1. So all that should be good news, I hope. Anyway, also, if you're interested in getting crypto, I suggest, please, come over to Voyager. That's the place. And they're going to give you, if you deposit $100, they will give you $50 in Bitcoin. And I will get $50 in Bitcoin for the referral. So if you decide to buy Luna, if you decide to buy Bitcoin, Shiba Inu, Stellar Lumens, just any crypto that they have on their platform, and you use my referral link, you'll get $50 in Bitcoin. I will get $50 in Bitcoin. That's all I've got for now. It's your girl, Allie. Hope you guys have had a magnificent day. You can see I'm just now getting the chance to finish completing the video. I will upload it now, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. I still have several videos I need to upload of just things I've had going on that I want to share. Can't wait to do it. It's your girl, Allie. Be sure to hit that subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up, and let's go!